Can we talk again about the same subject?
Alright, well, didn't...
Let's do...
Was those the only topics had? I think so, right?
Yeah, because right now it's Pokemon Go and the Turkey military coup are very big, so we started with those,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And we're rambling and rambling and rambling.
Lazo, what do you think about Mexico?
I don't like it right now because it has always had like corrupt politicians, like that's everywhere in the world, I think.
Please.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway, no comment.
Yeah, so...
Well, I actually think Mexico is worse than Turkey.
No, yeah.
Barbarian.
Yes, it's worse. Yes, it is.
Mexico is a lot worse because all the drug cartels and all that, it's...
That doesn't affect me, honestly, because I am high class, like, my family is rich, so
Ooh.
Nothing, I don't live in that environment. I am more like, basically, I am in the elite, I will say.
Yeah, the upper class.
Yeah, I'm in the upper class, so I live a comfy life, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But yes, like, for the poor, yes, it fucking sucks, dude. You fucking see them, and they are all these brown people that can fucking... get anything basically, and they are so fucking held down, you know. And they also vote these motherfuckers that hold them down into presidency and stuff like that. For example, right now our president is Peña Nieto, and he's fucking dumb, dude. Like, he's probably the worst candidate that was there out of the like three possible candidates, I think. Around the time, and they chose the most stupid one, just because he was handsome.
Kind of like how the Canadians did.
Yeah, basically. I don't know, but...
But the Canadians were also like, oh, this guy is like a super feminist. We need to vote him in.
No, luckily, that doesn't reach Mexico yet. Not as strongly as in the United States or Canada or Sweden.
Yeah, yeah. Sweden is starting to turn the other way. But I'm afraid... that the other way is going to be just as bad, you know, because the pendulum has swung so far left that when it swings back to the right, it's going to be extreme right.
Yeah, I fucking hate that too. I know what you mean, like...
Yeah, and the only one that gets injured is fucking me.
Yeah, exactly.
No matter who wins, I'm fucked, so why should I care?
Yeah, that's what I was actually thinking about. Yeah, I mean, who the fuck cares? Like, Lazul recently comment about this, and I was like... I mean, 2 days ago, I was furious, and I was, like, excited about this. I was like, what the hell is going on? And I realized what you realized, and I start to, like, just fuck it, man. Just,
like, but this- still, you... If you can participate like through voting or something like that, like I think that even though democracy is a fucking flawed system, it's worth participating in because I don't know, like.
Well, it doesn't really help that I vote for myself also, so it's like.
No, yeah, I'll.
They have one vote.
Always vote for yourself, dude. If.
Yeah, that's what I do. I just write my own name and give it to them.
Yeah. So
that one time I have voted because I haven't been old enough to vote more than once, but yeah.
But yeah, that's the thing that I know what you mean, Andreas. The extreme right, the fucking skinheads and all that stuff, like that could get to you someday, maybe if they get into power or something like that, because
yeah.
Those fucking guys. Those fucking guys are never going to tolerate, like, a dude with long hair and that likes My Little Pony, for example.
Yeah. I mean,
and
it's I already live in that world. Like I've said, the place I live in, it's a mixture between poor Swedes and poor immigrants.
Yeah.
The poor Swedes are skinheads, druggies, blah, blah, blah. And the poor immigrants are the extreme Muslims, this Slavic tribes or whatever, you know.
Alarukabar, yeah.
Yeah, so it's like, I already live in a shit area. So, and the fucking gangs that fight each other, I mean, they're both racist. Both the whites and the non-whites, both of them are racist.
Yeah, obviously.
I mean,
it's just like if you had KKK against Black Lives Matter, you know?
Yeah, they're both racist
yeah. Basically, like, on paper, they're both racist.
and in real life.
No, yeah.
So, I mean, I hate them both. I mean, I want none of them to win. It's like, well, don't you think it would even would he don't you think it would be better than this now? Maybe for some it probably would, for others it wouldn't, you know? I mean, fuck me. I think for me personally, it might even become worse because I live in a part of town that has a little more skinheads. You know? So, I mean, because we fled from the part that had more immigrants. So, yeah. So it's like, the safest place we can move to, that we have enough money to move to, is the skinhead part. So, yeah.
Guys, you know what? Just
It helps that my mom is part or was born in Germany, so
Oh, do you have
yeah.
dual citizenship?
Both me and my mom is actually an immigrant because she was born in Germany and came to Sweden.
Oh, is that why you hate German?
I hate Germany for many reasons.
But that's one of them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not really. That's not one of them because my mom being born in Germany doesn't really
Yeah,
affect me
I
anything.
mean, I was trying to connect the dots.
I mean, I hate Germany because of all the bullshit they feed us and because they have so left wing. And I've been in Germany once in Frankfurt, and this town smells like fish. It smells like shit.
That's
The
really
Germans
shitty
are fucking
reason to hate the
awful.
country, man.
The Germans are awful people. I just fucking hate Germans, you know.
Yeah, I guess.
Just like I hate Swedes and Greeks and Iranians and Iraqis. I hate everyone.
Know.
And I fucking hate Greece. I have dual citizenship too, which wasn't my choice or my mother's. My dad secretly wrote me down as a Greek citizen.
Yeah. Wait, you're
And
a Greek citizen now?
I'm both Greek and Swedish. I was born in Sweden. I've been lived in Sweden my whole life.
Greek, Sweden, and German then?
I
And
don't have
and
German
Jewish.
citizenship. I also have some, like,
Dude,
I don't
you
know, like
can
what.
represent multiculturalism.
Yeah, I am not Mongol. Well, I am part Mongoloid because I have like 1% East Asian in me, but I'm like 30% Middle Eastern. But the thing is, when they say Middle Eastern, they also include Cyprus and Turkey. And I'm like, come on, there is difference between Turkic because they're basically steppe people. And well, the deep call because my grandparents on my mother's side migrated from Greece from the Caucasus Mountains,
Yeah.
because they fled from because they were atheists, so they had to flee from there because I don't know, there was some war where people that were not either Christian or Muslims were being killed, so they fled to Greece.
Yeah.
And then from Greece, they went to Germany. They got some job in Germany. They got my mom. Then they moved to Sweden. And then when my mom was like 14, when she was in school, they moved back to Greece. But my mom didn't know, so when she came home, they had moved away. And my mom did not want to move to Greece because, well, she's like me. She's like, why should I move to Greece? That's a shit place to live in when
Yeah.
I can live in Sweden. So she started working in Sweden. And here I am. I was born now.
Nice.
She made the right decision, I think.
Yeah. sadly, my dad had to fuck everything up and write me as also Greek citizen, which means that the Greek state, because in Greece, is I think it's like Turkey, where you have to take military draft. What's it called?
You have to go to the military, do some training and stuff like that, and then...
Like, I'm not doing that. I'm never going back to Greece. Even though we have managed to get, like, essentially, because I am genetically inferior, so I've gotten, like...
You can do military drills, right? You can do military drills and stuff like that.
Yeah, I can't physically do it, so I've gotten, like... It's called, like, a pardon. But if there's a draft, they will still say... Come on here and die. I'm like, no. I'm not doing that.
No, fuck them, dude. What they have...
I don't give a fuck about
you. They have done nothing for you, dude.
Yeah, they have made my life worse.
Exactly.
So why the fuck should I?
Fuck those dudes. Yeah.
I have to go to military. But because of recent events... I don't know. They might even, just... I don't know what the hell is going to happen. Like,
don't go. Be like.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to go to college after university anyway. So, like, first 4 years, I'm okay.
You're 25, right? Barbarian or something like
that.
Yeah,
I am 21.
21. Okay.
21.
Yeah, 21.
How old are you, Lazul?
I am 22.
22, nice.
Yeah.
22, Jesus, you're the oldest.
I'm the oldest and I look the youngest here.
Wait.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, so,
I'm 20. Yes, I was born in 96. Yes, I'm 20 now. Oh, fuck me. I want to become 13 again. I want to go back.
You two were just born to see the world fuck itself
crumble.
Yeah, crumble.
Yeah.
I don't like the political climate of the world right now, to be honest.
Yeah, it's very unstable.
Yeah, I think so too.
What?
The political climate the world is facing right now.
Yeah.
It's fucking
fragile. It's very unstable.
Especially how these elections affected the world as well. Like even if the United States.
But that's because we live like in a global economy now.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
All countries affect each other.
Yeah.
You know, that's one of the very bad things about the global economy is the fact that now things that happen in other countries affect you a lot. You know.
Well, at least you can feel them affect you.
And especially here in Sweden, where we're like Neo-America, here people would really want to be Americans, but they want to be like the super leftist Americans, you know?
Yeah.
That's probably why we are so, so left, you know, here. Because people are like super overcompensating.
Yeah, and you're in the middle of all this conflict, like, I just want to make YouTube videos, man, like, leave me alone.
Andreas doesn't even want to do that.
Wait, you don't even want a YouTube channel or what?
Well, it doesn't really matter to me. That's the thing. Alright, the YouTube channel. Alright, sure. I mean,
if there
I enjoy
is,
making
I'll take
the
it,
videos.
But if there is not there...
If there, I wouldn't care. Alright.
Yeah.
I'll go back and do what I did before, you know. Paint video games. Paint miniatures, play video games, and...
yeah.
Not do anything else.
Guys, find the idea, and I'll turn it into a video, like find a viral video idea, and I'll turn it into a video, and we can split the revenue.
Just one thing, Andreas. Whatever you do, please don't delete your channel. Never do it. I like your channel a lot, man.
Yeah, I probably won't. I mean. The problem is that I have so many channels.
Yeah, I know.
I think I have like.
Dude, if Andreas wanted to delete the channels, he would feel lazy and he wouldn't do it because like there are seriously a lot of channels.
I mean, not only the ones
channels,
I have
right?
Andreas Peahc. I have like, I think 22 total.
Oh my fucking gosh! Oh my god!
Andreas is an extreme nihilist, man. Like, I thought I was a nihilist. I'm nihilist slash Muslim, by the way, if any anyone is listening.
Yeah.
But, you know, like, Andreas is taking to extreme.
Yeah.
No comment on that, because what true. The fuck does it matter?
Yeah, it's like, it's true. I mean, there's no purpose to anything. We're all going to die.
I believe in what Nietzsche says, but I don't like nihilism. Because I think that the purpose you have is a purpose you have to make that purpose, but you have to go through nihilism to make up that purpose, you know? You know what I mean?
Wait, I don't... What's prop?
I can't know what you mean.
You don't have a purpose, right, Andreas? You feel like that, right?
Wait, what are you... Propose
your...
Oh!
Your goal, right?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so, okay.
So you have to forcibly go through nihilism to make a goal yourself, right? So it's okay, right? Like
I don't know. I don't have any goal that I can think of.
Yeah.
Like the only goal I probably have is like finish my fucking Astra Militarum and Seraphon army. Oh, this fucking painting. Seraphon I'm painting right now. I'm doing each individual scale for a long time because I want it to look random. And if things doesn't look random enough, I'm like, I have to do it all over again. I have to do it all over again because... Or else I'll just kill myself. Because I get cold sweats, which is like a problem I have when it comes to painting. Like, because I'm not the greatest painter. But if things doesn't turn out the way I want, I'm like, oh god, I need to do it all over again. And if I don't, I start sweating and like, I start panicking.
I see.
Which is why this fucking little lizard guy has taken like a year to paint. And he's not even 50% done. I'm still working on the scales on the main body. I haven't done... I'm planning on having two heads for him. He's gonna have a carriage on him. I haven't done that. I haven't built it yet. Oh, man. Never... To the people listening, if you manage to get this far, never get into a tabletop. Don't do it. Save yourself the trouble.
We were already talking about this, you and I. That how it's filled with social justice warriors and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's like, why are they coming after tabletop? I mean,
even if they don't like it. They don't even like that shit.
Oh man. Yeah, it's fucking I fucking hate. I hate their fandoms in general.
Yeah.
And the tabletop community is like a completely sex-starred community, you know?
Yeah, obviously they are a bunch of nerds. Idiots.
Yeah, but they're not the good type of nerds. They're not the type of nerd that I am. That's what I'm basically saying.
Yeah.
Man, I fucking hate all the people I used to play with have turned. Oh, what happened? What fucking happened? Such good days of just painting miniature, having fun. And then all of a sudden, after the gaming group got dismantled, everyone turned on each other and they started chasing vagina.
Yeah, basically.
Well, there is a funny thing about this is that they fail. You know, they don't get any. So that's something that brings a smile to my face for a couple seconds. Ruined one of the few things I actually enjoyed.
You destroyed everything!
Yeah. That's basically what fans do. Fans destroy everything.
Fans.
Fandoms.
Yeah, fandoms. Humans.
Okie dokie, Andreas. Okie dokie.
When something gets too big, it's ruined.
Yeah, I can understand the mainstream effect, but like I said...
Even if it doesn't get big, they will destroy it.
Sure, why not?
So, Andreas...
I think it's human nature to destroy everything good.
It is, it seems it is. It's like a cycle. So let's get more philosophical here, Andreas. What keeps you going in life, basically?
My fear of death.
Really? Only that? And you wouldn't like to see your channel grow or make money from it or something like that? You don't have any future plans for your channel?
No. No.
No. And that's it.
The only reason for the channel, spend time, you know.
On something, yeah.
Yeah, and also I get some enjoyment out of it, you know. I would have never played
Dark Souls.
Some of the games. Yeah, if it wasn't for the channel. You know, if it wasn't for you two.
Yeah, like, so you find it fun. You're enjoying it, right? So your channel...
But I don't enjoy it enough to actually put...
Effort.
Effort, you know?
Okay, I see. It's okay, I still like your videos, dude.
Yeah.
They keep me going.
You know? That's nice to hear.
No, like, they are part, like, of my life. Like, every day I go into your channel to see if you have anything new. And I see, oh, okay, he doesn't have anything new. Then I go to another channel and stuff like that. But your channel is becoming very, like, it's a very core part of my life, I think, I guess. Like, when I turn on the computer, I check your channel almost every day, dude. Because I think your content is pretty fucking fun.
That brings something into perspective for me.
No, yeah, seriously. Maybe other of your viewers think like that as well.
You didn't think some people enjoy your videos?
Well, I do know some people do, because there's so many private messages I get. Most of the messages I get is private. The thing is, I'm getting so many that I'm like, I can't keep up anymore, you know? I used to respond to everything, but...
Wow!
Even though the comments on the regular videos, there's not that many. I'm like, but the private messages that I get, there's so many, like... And they're so long, like, I can't, you know?
Yeah. Wait, okay, I just checked my messages, see if there's anything new. The last message is 3 months ago, and okay, except Lazul, and Lazul wrote top 10s hook a lot of people for a reason, so I recommend you looking for into that. Sorry, man, I just saw that about top 5, top 7 videos. Oh, you want
to...
Top 5.
No, I was just telling you because the previous podcast we were talking about how you would like to get videos with many views, right?
Yeah, I actually would like that. I'm not like Andreas. I want that.
Yeah, so top 10 videos, top 7s, top 5s. Top videos basically get a lot of views for a reason.
Yeah, I understand.
So I'm telling you that.
You know, don't you think it's a little bit late for that?
No, because they still get so many viewers and
For example,
so many.
You could make a video about your top 10 about your favorite Dark Souls weapons, Dark Souls 3 weapons in Dark Souls, and everyone's going to watch that too, just to hear your opinion. They don't care, like, they don't care what's in the top one. They are going to comment anyway and stuff like that. They are going to view all the video and shit like that. So that's a good way to get views.
Lazul, by the way, what did you mean by this message? Because it was the end of the video, and was that the joke? Like,
it's a fucking meme that 9/11, dude. The Twin Towers.
How did I forget that? Right, of course. I mean, I didn't even think about that.
Yeah. Gamer, if you want to become... Gamer, what did I say? Gamer. Barbarian. If you want to become popular, just do, like, super memes everywhere.
Yeah, spam memes, do top videos, put some tits on the thumbnails, and you will get views like crazy.
Because I'm kind of anti that, because when I started noticing, especially on my second channel, Andreas Peahc 2, when some videos started getting, like, these super normy comments... And I started, people started saying that it started to become a meme on Facebook. I started panicking. I was like, oh no, what am I supposed to do? I don't want them here. I don't want
but
them to
dude,
watch my
I don't
here.
Understand. I mean, like, I mean, just views are always good. What does it matter?
Not always, because the thing is that, also Barbarian, some people care about making a community out of their channel.
Yeah, I totally understand that. But, you know, like, haters are, like, people who don't like your content is not going to stay there forever. Maybe, like, how many times they are going to comment about your you know, something they don't like. You know, they are going to do it one week.
But that's not a problem. That's actually not the problem.
He's worried about attracting the normies.
That,
I don't know.
Yeah, that they are going to comment. I fucking hate when people say, like, oh, that's so me, XD. True.
Relatable.
Yeah, you're nothing like me, piece of shit.
Or fucking memesters.
I hate that so cringy when people say, it's so relatable with this particular celebrity.
Yeah.
Can you relate?
And that was one of the worst things. That today might not be too bad video I made. Then... After that, I was like, I was wrong part one, I was wrong part two. Those three videos, I don't know why, but they became like one of the most popular videos, you know, when I look at the traffic that comes from them. podcast is mostly from, you know, Google search.
It was from...
It's so weird that people specifically Googled for those videos.
Okay, I see. So it wasn't 4chan, right?
Yeah, it's not like my book review, which is like fucking 90%, 98% like 4chan. Yeah. And it's still going. It still keeps coming in. Like, yeah. Hello?
Yeah, yeah. I understand, man.
Oh, Barbarian disappeared. All right.
No, yeah. Barbarian is like lagging. Who knows?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have been in 4chan for a long time, dude. Like, I can tell you right now that you pick up a good board. TG is very good. I lure JP because of the... I like Toho.
Yeah, Toho.
So that's my shit, basically. And yeah, just like you, I hate fucking memesters, too. Yeah. They are the fucking worst. Like, fucking normie memesters are fucking annoying, dude. What happened, by the way, Barbarian?
Suddenly my internet was gone. I didn't really understand. Anyway.
The government. The hacking.
Yeah, thing. They actually have power to do that without showing any reason right now. So, not much change. Okay, what were we talking about? I actually write that down, stuff I need to ask. You mentioned a website, Andreas, other than 4chan, that made you more famous? Oh, hello, man.
What's up, dude?
Facebook. Oh, shit.
That's my hair, by the way.
You are so beautiful.
Yeah, thank you, man.
Man,
how's this?
Like, really nice hair.
Hey, your hair is longer than mine. Come on, what are you saying?
Well, I guess, I don't know, man.
Dude, you are so
like,
not...
Yeah, it's really...
Like, by the way, I don't know how are you going to take this, but you are so not the Mexican I was expecting.
Yeah,
obviously not.
When I think Mexican, I think...
Like... Brown people, basically.
Yeah, like with a sombrero and like 14 kids.
No, yeah, it's understandable.
What do you think about Turks, Lezu?
Turks?
Yeah, like kind of shape and image you recall?
Well, they are...
They are interesting people. I don't know anything about them.
They are like you, like they are Arabs. And at least I think that Turkey is like one of the best countries on the Middle East, I think, I guess.
Yeah, we are. I think for a long time, I think we still are, but I think for a long time, we were the America of Middle Earth because Arabians, Iraq, I mean, all of the Middle East, like, watch our television. You know, they said, oh my God, I want to go to Turkey one day and I want to be free as them. And I was what are you talking about? What were we talking about? Yeah,
you were talking about freedom.
Yeah, Middle Eastern, South. Because I saw an Azerbaijan guy from Azerbaijan and said, you know, Turkey was the country I look up to. Like, one day I'm going to go there. And I was like, why? Why are you doing this? Are you sure that's the Turkey?
Because he's from Azerbaijan. Come on. I would also want to leave.
Yeah, but right now, I mean, Azerbaijan is better. I think so, Azerbaijan.
Well, it's also because Azerbaijan is basically like, it's a shithole, let's be honest. It's still, and it's always going, there's still very tribal mindset, you know, like, just one day, some stranger's gonna come into your house and steal your daughter. Fine.
It's just Azerbaijan and Turkish language is so similar. Like, it wouldn't be a problem for me to go there and live there, like, right now. It's basically like English and American English.
Yeah,
except,
yeah.
You know, it's a real language. Anyway, I actually write down this stuff. Did you tell me the website you mentioned? Like, other than 4chan? Do you remember?
Yeah, it was... Facebook. I started.
I thought I found a secret website that I can promote videos.
No, but yeah. So, Andreas, you were. I remember that you were announced on Facebook, right? But you didn't like that shit because you told that those guys were normies, right?
Yeah, because the certain influx of just super meme comments and I broke down.
Just like me, man. Stuff like that.
Yeah, I broke down. Yeah. So I made like 1 hour of footage of me just going on Facebook. I had to create a fucking Facebook page or whatever it's called just to be like, look at this fuck. And I freaked out. And then the next day I was like, who gives a fuck? But at that point of time, I was freaking out. I was like, oh no. Oh no, they found me. I have to stop making videos now. I have to go and do something else. Like, I started a completely new channel.
Andreas, you do realize you're an internet meme. Like, it's official.
Yeah, I guess.
Okay,
it's
this is
awful.
Okay, this is not even.
I don't know what kind of meme I am, but I'm sure I am.
Just check the image. I mean, you probably can't see your image. Like.
Yeah, I can see it now, and this is exactly the one I meant.
Admin
this
rules.
Is the one.
Limit sharing unless the joke comes from its source. What the fuck is this? Never post or
Never
share anything.
Share anything Nazi related.
What? I mean, why didn't you just set racism? That's too specific. Oh, good.
Yeah, this exact thing is the thing that made me freak out. Because this is, I think, was what got popular in, like, the Facebook thing. People just started, or maybe it was Twitter. Might be even both, I don't remember. But people started sending, oh, I saw this here, here. I was like, oh, no. Oh, no.
I did some wrong things with my YouTube channel, man. Like, I didn't accept it first because it was working for me. In the long term, I shouldn't have cared this much. I mean,
yeah, I guess.
Yeah, but
I mean,
did you go troll or something? What do you mean with that?
No, I'm not talking about trolling.
No, he means that he has put like too much time. Is that what you mean?
Yeah, but that you can say.
Yeah, for example, when you did all those games of games you don't even give a fuck about. All these indie games, you know, like, or whatever, what are they called? These games that are just made to get popular.
Meme
on YouTube.
Games are. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, I guess. I mean, those videos were absolute shit. Like, fuck me, I can't watch.
But now you're doing Pokemon Go, so you're going to get a lot of views guaranteed later on, right? We're not talking like right now.
Like, I feel like my channel died a long time ago, and I'm just rolling in the ashes and hoping that it's going to turn to a bird that's on flame. I forget what it's called.
Yeah, like a phoenix.
Yeah, phoenix. I just forget the name, but you get my analogy.
Yeah, you're gonna rebirth.
But, I mean, okay. Probably it's not going to happen.
Well, if you make videos like the Call of the Worst one or like those fucking
dude, okay,
five,
you say that,
10.
You say that, but what the fuck is a video like Call's Word? That was a one-time thing. Also, did you know?
Yeah, I think that video took advantage of the situation with video games right there. Like around that time, fucking Fallout 4 was popular as fuck.
Yes.
So your video was
yeah. So like when another one of these, well, probably other people are probably gonna be able to do it much faster than you will.
Why? Why are you challenging me right now? I can do faster than that. Faster than them.
Yeah, I'm sure you probably could, but will you? Is the
oh,
because
nice. Okay.
Is everyone alive?
I am
What's
alive.
Happening?
Yeah, yeah.
By the way, did you know Red Dead Redemption is now compatible with Xbox One, or was it PC?
What? Well,
whatever. I think Red Dead Redemption got an update or something like that, because my video about Red Dead Redemption got a little bit popular. Like, it got 500 views in a month. And
well, it's probably because of that mod. There's a GT5 mod where it is like Red Dead Redemption style.
Wait,
I meant to search for that shit.
What do you mean mod? How the fuck mod affects it? I was talking about this.
I fucking hated Fallout 4. So I couldn't stand playing more than just the first 10 minutes.
Oh, wait. Dude, you gotta understand.
That was fucked up.
Andreas, are you talking about my video?
No, he's talking about Fallout 4 in general. I'm glad I didn't buy that game, dude. Because
I want to apologize again to Bubby, because Bubby actually bought the game for
me. Yeah, that's the thing, man. I mean, if somebody bought the game for me, I would just play the sake of that. I mean, it's not like it's torture machine. It's a game.
Well, it is.
It is for me.
And, I mean, the only reason I even made this review, well, it wasn't a review.
Oh.
The only reason why I made a video was to be like, see, Bubby, I put some effort into this. I mean,
And Bubby
why
said,
did you do it, Bubby? Why did you do it?
Also, Bubby also didn't like the Fallout 4. That's interesting.
Yeah.
So you did actually good by not liking it. Dude,
yeah.
Whatever you do in YouTube, it just works for you, man. And whatever I do, it doesn't work for me.
Well, I wouldn't say 600,000 plus views is not working.
Yeah, but you are also growing. You have a community.
But Andreas started smaller than you did. So you have to take that into account.
Smaller than me?
Yeah, he started smaller than you. Don't you think? Because you got a lot of most of your subscribers came from the Fallout video, right?
Yes, but before and that, I was from 4chan. Videos. Like,
but who has more subscribers, you or him?
I have, but
a lot more.
Yeah.
In terms of views and subscribers, I think I got the upper hand, but. You know,
yeah.
It is
because if I combine my both channels, so all my channels, I think I have like 1,000.
1,000? That's not as much as I thought it would. Anyway, you are still famous on 4chan, by the way. People still share your video.
Yeah, 4chan, believe it or not. Well, what's up, dude?
Lazo, don't you think like he should use this as an opportunity? Like, don't you think he could manage to get a lot bigger by this? Because 4chan means, like, it's a blast on internet.
No, yeah.
Well, I have to basically...
I understand what you're saying, but...
memeing around.
Will Andreas enjoy that community? Will he, like...
No.
that's a question, yeah. So, if you don't like it, don't do it, dude.
I know you're fucking watching the guy who's probably posting those shit.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking do what you want, but I don't want you to do it.
Yeah, I understand.
You can if you want, you can spam barbarians.
The thing is that 4chan loves weird people. They have always liked weird people. And you, Andreas, you are like authentic. You are yourself, basically, which is not common in the real world, right? Like you're not a normie by all means.
Yeah, like a piece of coal in I don't know what analogy I was gonna say there, but.
Yeah, your channel is fucking good. I like it. Yeah, that's it.
Promoted on Reddit and it was on front page. It's Craig WL, and you know, like he got famous quickly for a while.
Yeah, he got a lot of subscribers. That for sure. Yeah.
Yeah, because just because he uploaded a lot of videos without having a lot of views, and you know, people appreciated that. You can check the What the Hell Happened video here, like if you want to watch this. I mean, it's basically ask what the hell happened. And
yeah.
I commented, congrats, man, I hope this won't be a one thing for you. Guess what? It fucking was!
The barbarian curse.
It's not my fault, you. Why are you trying to blame me? Lazul, by the way, do you have any ambitions about whether you in YouTube or, you know, education?
Yeah, you want to become a streamer.
In YouTube, in YouTube, I would like to become a streamer, dude. Like, very much. I will love it. And I feel like I have what it takes to get there, to be honest. But what I don't have right now, the only thing I am lacking is the most important thing, which is a powerful PC. Yeah, equipment, basically. But the skills, I can get there very easily. And I am a tier whore, so I'm going to use the best tools I know of to kill... a lot of people in Dark Souls 3.
Dark Souls 3, yeah, okay. But the most important thing about streaming any kind of entertainment, whether it's YouTube, whether it's stand-up comedian, is promoting.
It's good looks.
Good luck as well, but...
Dude, good looks helps you everywhere. It doesn't matter. Andreas, don't act like a child. Have you ever met Louis C.K.?
Okay, Barbarian. Promoting work, how do you mean promoting yourself? Okay.
Yeah,
you mean like in Twitter, Facebook?
Oh,
you mean like
sure.
Those places?
Yeah, sure.
I wouldn't like to use Facebook because the thing is that I will not like to have my like normies as a community for my channel. I will fucking hate them, you know?
Yeah, I understand, but if you want to make a living from this, I mean, you need views. Like, I mean, you need.
Oh yeah, obviously, I understand.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
I understand that. Yeah.
And under okay, what I understood about YouTube viewers, like they wanna find you, but they don't want to be told that they are going to find you. Like obviously, you can push yourself. And maybe I did that. Like I don't think I did that a lot, but maybe I did it. So, you know, like, you need to promote without promoting. You need to, like, you need to show that you don't care, but I also need to I also care. Is it clear? I don't think it is, because it's a very interesting thing. And that's why Andreas was lucky, because in 4chan, other people cared about to share, cared enough to share, and Andreas got a community. Andreas, it doesn't matter.
We are the community of Andreas. We are the ones who find him, who found him in 4chan, basically.
Yeah,
I mean, I'm basically talking to my and I talk to my community more than I talk to anyone else.
My mom.
Yeah, probably.
The thing is, in 4chan, you don't know what you're going to get. Like, you will get a random community. You can get, like, fucking faggots are never going to shut the fuck up. And, you can get, like, nice guys to have around, you know, like you and I.
Yeah, I understand that. I'm not, like, telling you to promote on 4chan. I'm just saying, I'm showing you an example.
I will actually like to promote myself on 4chan. Oh. Because I like the community in 4chan. I'm used to it. I know if I get the trolls, if I get trolls and memesters, I know how to ignore them and stuff like that. So it's not a problem for me. But you know what I mean? Like, if I can get the nicer parts of 4chan, that will be ideal for me. Mm-hmm. Ideal, yeah.
No, I understand, but I was just giving an example, because, like, to get views, okay, YouTube works like, YouTube is not going to promote you because you are small. To YouTube promote you, you need to be bigger, and to be bigger, you need other websites.
Yeah, I guess that as well. So I will make a Reddit, maybe. I don't like Reddit very much, but
no, I'm just saying, like, I had a lot of dreams about this. I thought it would be easier to grow, and it was kind of easier at first when I had a big video a couple of times. And I thought, like, hey, this is not that hard, but of course it didn't continue. I'm just saying to prepare you for that, like, if you ever think like that.
Well, I do think like that, and I don't want to grow. I will like to grow very fast when I get the videos started. But I'm not exactly sure how. So if you can share me some tips, go ahead, dude. They will be very welcome.
Tips? I've been waiting for this moment, like, since I created my YouTube channel.
Yeah.
No, not really. Okay.
So,
There is no tip that's going to gain more subscribers.
That is actually a good question, because I have no idea how anyone even discovered. I mean, how do anyone even discover anyone on YouTube?
From recommended videos.
No, when I think
most
about
of
it,
my views comes from recommended videos. But to get recommended, you need views, and to get views, you need views from other websites. Which, for me, or like most of the YouTubers, use Reddit, because that's the most logical reason, most logical option, don't you think?
I guess I was lucky then, because
Andreas, you have no idea. You are so
anything.
Lucky. But it's just you shouldn't forget that this is mostly about luck, because it really is. And I can tell you from the first hand, like, even PewDiePie doesn't have, like, any idea how the fuck he gained these subscribers. He just made videos, like, you know, he was good with editing with Adobe Premiere Pro or something. But, you know, he has no idea why he has so many subscribers, except other than the right time in the right place, which that's kind of obvious.
I guess that might be what for me also, because...
Yep.
Now when I look at my oldest video, the first of the oldest video that it seems like got me any attention was my Evil Goyen video.
Uh-huh.
Where it is like Unter Alterbach. That one has 19,000 views. So I'm guessing now when I look at this, that probably someone saw it, subscribed to me, then saw those other videos that I started doing with the book review. And that's probably how I got cursed.
Curse!
But,
what are you talking about?
What I think I will have to do, like, more into in the Dark Souls community is, like, I will have to join, like, fight clubs and fight real streamers like Ouroboro, Scott, Big Cat Logan, people that are already popular. Fight them, get like head to toe with them, get like good fights going, and then the subscribers will come like automatically, because they will like to know who are you, like this guy is pretty good as well and stuff like that. Like so, in any competitive game, like.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's actually a good idea, but how are you going to fight with the bigger YouTubers? Like, do you know them? I think you told me you know one of them, right?
Yeah, I know one of them. Like, I know two of them, but the other one, removed me from his friend list in Steam. But when I need it, I will add him again. But the only one I have right now is like Silvermont, which is a dude that makes lore videos.
That's
I think that
for
I,
you, man.
I already share. Yeah, because he's a good fighter too.
Oh, I hope you don't lose.
What?
I hope you don't lose the fight.
No. I am tier whore. I won't lose. I know my shit.
I mean,
and I am so sure of myself.
It's an incredibly huge advantage that you have someone like that on your side. I mean, like,
yeah,
to be honest,
exactly.
For me, anyone that's
I feel like right now, yeah. I do feel like right now in YouTube you can grow if you don't like befriend the people that are already popular, you know? So
you can,
that's
okay,
one of the gateways I'm going to take.
Okay, wait. I didn't hear the
like
heard
it,
after,
like okay
after,
so
before the
for
gateway
me,
for what
me,
was the no, gateway?
Okay, the gateway for me to grow in YouTube will be like making like collaborations with these bigger Dark Souls YouTubers, you know?
Yeah, that's
like
that's the best plan ever.
Or Batty Media, whatever. Only Apple, whatever. You know?
I think so.
Like, well, you can like you. The only thing you need is like to not be afraid of doing what you like, basically. So what I did was just try to add for example Silvermont and Only Afro to my friend list, and they accepted. Like they don't care who you are. Like don't worry. I mean don't be shy. That's what I mean. You know,
dude.
Especially if you know that you have the skills to go toe in toe with them or something like that.
No, I understand, but I'm not shy. I mean, I'm never shy, especially when it comes to YouTube. I actually emailed, right? Okay, Andreas, actually, for me, like, I thought, you know, it's not like I didn't thought it would be fun to make a podcast, but I also thought, you know, Andreas' community could help to my channel.
Yeah, because you were the one who asked me, like,
yes,
let's make a podcast. Like, yeah.
Yeah,
sure.
If I was shy, I wouldn't ask Andreas either. Because I realized that Andreas is a little bit nihilist. And I realized it was extreme nihilist. He was extreme nihilist. Anyway, I did this video with Watiwa, and he got a lot of subscribers. It didn't even help. It just, that's okay. When I first started YouTube, I thought that, hey, okay, these people use lag, but what triggers lag? I need to find that and I need to do that. But it just doesn't happen for me sometimes, and it just, I don't know. Okay, maybe there are a lot of things I do wrong. If you see them, you can tell me, Lazo.
No, so I think that video is pretty good. It's the Overwatch one, right? I think I already watched it. Yeah, so
yeah,
one of the things that it's going to get you, I think that one of the things that is going to get you a lot of fucking views and subscribers is going to be like doing collaborations with other YouTubers. If you can do that 24/7, like if you can do that every time, do so, please, dude, because you're basically sharing like two communities there, your community with his community, and his subscribers are going to come to you. You're helping each other, basically.
Yeah, I understand that, but you know, my views are so low, I feel like it will be unfair to ask
you are, like you are a fake, you feel like you are affecting them negatively, right?
yeah
I mean, so about that,
The problem is views, not subscribers, by the way. Because, I mean, Andreas has less subscribers than me, but more views than me.
Depends on the video.
Yeah, depends on the video, I guess.
Because my gameplay videos tend to get like 20 views, and it's often the same 20 people, which is nice.
Mm-hmm.
But the vlogs, I guess we do call it, or the real life videos, they tend to always have even more. And the podcast seems to be doing like great. I don't know why or how.
Yeah, the podcast did really good. I think that it's because it has the keywords for it.
Because you have me.
Yeah.
It could be. It could be, I think. But also because of the topics we talk about. We talk about feminism and all that, and that shit is very viral right now. So maybe that is.
But, I mean, reasons. To make a video viral, we need to make it short. Like, so, Andreas, don't accept podcasts to go viral.
No, but the thing is that the community of Andreas enjoys podcasts a lot. They think that they are very comfy. That's what I
realized. Oh, check this out. Exactly when you search my name, you can see the podcast if you search it without space.
Yeah.
You can see the podcast, really? Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah.
I am okay, fucked.
So maybe.
Maybe. Well, you can also see that messing around Overwatch.
Yes, that's the video I collaborated with a bigger YouTuber. But, like, it so didn't affect. It made me sad, honestly.
Well, I mean, you have to think, alright, that video got 4,300 views.
Yeah, it didn't affect, like, 10 views or something. Like, that's how effective it was.
Then the amount of people that are gonna click to your channel might be, let's say, 1%. That would be 40. And then of those people that are then actually gonna click a video, might be like 10%, 20%. Like that brings it down to like, how many is that? Like 15 views. And how many of those 15 are gonna stay? Let's say like 50% of those 15 stay. That's 7.
Mm-hmm. By the way,
you know,
this video probably be the most helpful video. Because it helped the creators of game to get a little bit more disclose.
Wait, what did it do?
Like, I don't know, people I guess downloaded the game because apparently it helped the game. Developer come and wrote, "Glad you had fun, you helped disclose. Thank you so much, thank you so. This game is Brazilian, done by me and my friends, thanks again." And I was like, yeah, baby, fun. Yeah, those are the days, man. Like, those are the days. I was getting 15 views a day. Whoa! Fucking bitches and getting 50 views.
Still, I do think that collaboration videos are one of the best ways to get views fast.
Yeah, sure, definitely.
It makes sense, right? Because even the, I don't know, the fucking haters of PewDiePie, they make a hate video towards PewDiePie and they get a fucking lot of views because of the name PewDiePie. Lots of random stupid people search for it, you know?
Yeah,
basically brand recognition is what you want.
Sorry, what? Brand recognition?
Brand recognition, basically. You want people to
basically maybe
like know the name.
Yeah, okay.
Gamer the Barbarian.
Like difference between Pokemon and Ingress. Ingress is a game like Pokemon, but you know, how many people know Ingress?
Yeah.
What the fuck is that, dude? I don't even
know. Yeah, but you don't even know what Ingress is. It's basically the same with Pokemon, but without Pokemon.
I know Digimon, but Ingress,
No, it's a mobile game. It's not an anime or something. It's just a mobile game.
It's the same company that did Pokemon
Exactly.
Go.
Did you search it?
Okay. I'm searching for it.
No, I knew it before because someone in my class used to play. Well, it's not really a play game, right? It's more like augmented reality.
Yeah, like Pokemon? like there's the portals in the world, like Pokestops, and you go there.
I only know of the name and the company. Niantic, right?
Okay, yes, it's all hacking Ingress.
Ah, Lizzle, by the way, you said about something different. You said something about being different on YouTube. Like, how do you think you are going to be different? Do you have ideas?
No, but
maybe if that's so unique, don't tell us.
I'm not going to be different. Like, I'm going to do PvP videos and gank spankings and stuff like that. That's all I would like to do, honestly. But
I mean, you can get the Spanish speaking world, you know, on your side.
Yeah, basically yes, but I feel like I'm limiting myself if I speak Spanish, to be honest. So maybe that wouldn't be a good idea. Who knows? We will see.
Yeah. I wouldn't. That depends. I mean, it's the same shit if I started doing videos in Swedish. I mean, I might do some, you know, but
yeah, if you did videos in Swedish, I couldn't, like, you wouldn't have me in your community because I wouldn't understand what the fuck you're saying, you know?
Yeah, that's the thing. It's like, I guess if there ever was like some topic that was like just that, like, all right, this would just be for Swedish people.
Mm-hmm.
Might, but then again, it would probably be better to just do it in English anyway, so that, well, other people can understand it other than Swedish. That's the power of the English language. It's like, it's
a language for the internet.
Everything. Yeah.
The language of the
internet. And I prefer English than Swedish, actually.
You learned what? Sorry, what?
I prefer English to Swedish.
To Swedish.
Though,
okay.
Yeah. Even though my English is not as good as my Swedish, but
I like English too.
Let's so originality. I don't think originality gets a lot of views on YouTube, to be honest. Actually, it's the opposite. The more fucking copy of, the more memes you use, basically, the more views you're going to get.
Memes? Like, memes. What kind of memes you are talking about?
Fucking shitty memes that normies like, you know?
Too far away from these meme words? Am I out of touch?
No. I will have to show you an example, but
yeah, please.
But I don't know.
Okay, be right back, though.
Like only Afro in YouTube, like, most of his videos are spammed with memes.
Okay, wait. Save the things you are going to say to me.
Yeah, Barbarian is gonna leave for
a
minute or two.
Yes,
yeah.
Okay.
You know, the Turkish soldiers, or the Turkish police, is knocking at his door.
Oh, yeah, probably.
If we hear some gunshots, then we know what happened.
Yeah.
Have it all documented. Let me look. Yes, it's still recording. Alright, good.
That video. Watch that video, Andreas. By the way, lower the volume if you need to, whatever. But that fucking shit is full of meme and full of memes. And that guy is a Dark Souls YouTuber, you know? I had this guy in stream, actually. He's a really nice dude, to be honest. Like, I would like to make a video with him someday, maybe. I don't know. But first I need, like, popularity. First I need
I'm looking at it.
First I need the fucking computer.
I see a bunch of, like, Mountain Dew. And
yeah,
Overwatch.
My early gaming.
And Doritos. I'm watching the, like, Microsoft Sam. That's the thing, I like Microsoft Sam, though.
Yeah, me too, the voices of the default voices, you know? Yeah, but all this fucking video, like, honestly, when you think about this fucking
track. Alright. Lasul just cut out. What did you say?
Okay, I'm just saying that if you analyze that video, all that video, the edits he did, everything he did, it's fucking trash, you know? It's fucking trash.
Yeah, I mean...
It was pretty poorly made, you know? You can see that he didn't... He just spammed like...
A meme there. Yes. Some memes there.
Exactly.
And there you go. A million views.
Yeah, a fucking million views and 55 and 25 likes and stuff like that. Yeah. That's how this guy got popular. Also through 4chan, because this guy used to be a 4chaner as well. 4chaner and Reddit.
I guess the power of 4chan.
But yeah, that's what I'm saying. The fucking video is so fucking trash.
Yeah. Oh god.
Well, I actually had this dude on the stream. Only Afro and also this other dude. Let me find him. Silver. I still have...
Wait.
What? What is it?
Were you in their stream or were you streaming? And
No. I mean, I have them in Steam. Sorry.
Oh, Steam.
Yeah.
All right.
As friends.
Ah, nice.
I could play with them if I requested help from them or stuff like that.
Yeah.
Just do it as well. That dude is pretty... Right. He's pretty nice, to be honest. The guy.
And the guy I just sent is, like, another guy that I got introduced by a viewer who said, like, he found me through this guy. And then I started watching him, like... Yeah, the new storyteller.
He has a video. He has a video about you, or what?
No, the guy said he found me through this guy because I think I commented on one of these videos. I don't remember which. Then he found my comment through that because I found out about this guy through a podcast, the Procrastinators. I think it, and that's how I found this guy. And this another guy, like, I don't know, but I listen to it while I'm trying to sleep. That's basically how I have. I take one of these videos, because videos are like an hour or so, 37 minutes, you know, blah, blah, blah. I just play it, then I fall asleep. Yeah.
By the way, Andreas, I wonder, in your related channels, did you have Eugenia Corey, right? I think. Did you have a girl? It was an emo girl that was anorexic. Did you have her in your channel?
Oh yeah, Eugenia Cooney.
Yeah, that girl. I found her. I actually found her very interesting. To be honest, I subscribed to her because I saw her in your channel and I was wondering why the hell would he have this girl here, right? Because she is a. She is actually, like, honestly, she's a normie, right?
But yeah, she is.
She is a normie, honestly. But she has anorexia and, like, he gets shit for that and stuff like that. And this girl is, like, she doesn't give a fuck about what other people say, like, because she likes being like that, you know? And I do fucking respect that. Like, I'm like, okay, this girl has balls, you know?
Yeah, that's also the reason I can't watch her videos, however, because her videos are far too, you know,
normie.
Cringy for me. Not really cringy, because I don't really feel cringe. But they're like, I can't watch them, you know.
They're very normie, you mean, or what do you mean exactly?
Yeah, kind of. I mean, well, at least I just don't find them interesting. But I found her as a
person, you know,
as a person, like, yeah, interesting. Go ahead, you know.
Yeah, me too. I actually saw her in your channel, and I was like, why is Andreas recommending her? But, well, now I know. And yeah,
That's basically what I did. Then on my second channel, I was like, I probably shouldn't recommend people on that channel because of the way that it turned out at that time when there was like this super influx of, you know. So I was like, oh shit, I don't want to send these people to other people. Yeah.
What's up, bitches?
But now I guess I can go back to it, like...
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes. Okay. These like special people that like I find interesting. I might start, you know, putting them like something other than this.
Yeah, I understand that.
Like Eugenia, Cooney, Tara. Fuck.
She really looks like a fucking Tim Burton character. She honestly does. I do like that, to be honest. Like personally.
Yeah. Wait, you mean like, I completely spaced out. Did you say Tim Burton?
Yeah, she looks like a Tim Burton character.
Yeah. That's the guy who made Jack Skellington, right?
Yeah, Jack Skellington, yeah. And that's pronounced as Skellington, by the way. You're right there.
Skellington.
It's not a skeleton.
Yeah. That's probably where I started saying like Skellington when I mean skeleton. Yeah. But hey. She seems to enjoy it. Go ahead.
Well, yeah. She's probably super normie in real life.
Yeah. Judging by her videos, she probably is.
She is. She just watches basic anime. Fucking shit. Pokemon, she has a Pokemon Go video, she's normie. I gotta watch that shit later on. I'm going to.
Yeah.
All this shit and watch later.
Well, Barbarian, what do you think?
I'm not sure what you're talking about. Oh, that homeless woman. Are you talking about that?
Oh, no, not anymore. She's old news. We're talking about Eugenia Cooney.
Who is that?
You're better not knowing it. I think. Probably, I don't know.
The storyteller Silvermont?
Silvermont is pretty cool.
This guy, I have this guy in my friend list. Silvermont is in my friend list. And
yeah, I remember that you told me.
Yeah, and the DBA players, that's from only Apple, who I had him in my friend list, but not anymore, but if I wanted, I could have him again.
Did you ask him became famous in YouTube?
No, I have never asked him that, but I think that is because he was very...
obvious.
It's pretty obvious. Like, watch his video. It's full of memes, fucking memes, and people love memes.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Also because he was advertised in 4chan a lot. In BG, I think. In the Dark Souls general.
Dude, he promoted his video on 4chan and people like it?
I guess, yeah. Yes.
Andreas!
4chan is full of memesters, dude.
Yeah, I know that, but I mean, okay, you are talking about this Diva players, right? Is this the video you were going to show it to me?
Yeah, yes. Watch that video.
Oh
watch
my god, it got 1 million!
And look at the videos. It's pure trash. It's fucking shit, dude. And people like that shit.
It's just YouTube is a really weird place, man.
Yeah, exactly. They don't want originality, to be honest. And you told me that. You told me that how I was going to be original. If I wanted views, I will have to be unoriginal as fuck. I will have to go mainstream.
Dude, don't you think I know that? I am aware of that. Yeah, but that's the thing. If you do the same thing, people are going to say you are doing the same thing with this person. If you do different, nobody is going to like it and people are going to judge you. So you are better off, you know, better off with, if you are better off without
thinking doing what you like. Right?
Yeah, exactly. If you don't give a crap about what people think. But I mean, it affects you.
I don't give a fuck about what people think.
But
I
it
do
affects
not
you. It affects
so...
your view.
But all right, I won't say who cares because you obviously do, because
no,
because you want to be able to live off this.
Yes, obviously. I mean,
yeah.
Actually, me too. I would like to live from the internet, basically. To be honest.
Yeah, not because some 12 kids opinion, 12 years old kids opinion is so important.
Yeah.
But it is important in a sense.
I guess that's like my superpower then. I don't give a fuck.
Because you don't want to make a living out of it, Andreas.
Yeah, at least that's not
as
my goal or anything. It's like, hey, if I mean,
it's a side project, right?
Yeah, it might also be because I probably don't need it at the moment either. Like, I mean, there's gonna be years and years before I'm going to have to worry about any of this, so I'll take it then. And if I become homeless, well, then I'm homeless, I guess, you know.
The money, the money you make through YouTube is very little anyway, to be honest, right?
Barbarian, are you talking about me?
Yes.
Well, I think Barbarian actually made a lot.
Well, okay,
right?
Okay. I made a lot of money, but not in terms of, oh, I am rich money. But, okay, I bought this computer 1 year ago, and I made all the money to buy this computer again. So, you know, I basically cover my expenses.
Yeah, like alright.
And it's like 5 lira. I don't know how much in US dollar. It's probably something like 2000. Around
how much lira it was?
My computer was around 5000 lira.
Lira. Okay, 5000. You can make the conversion in Google, by the way. 5000 lira to dollars.
So like $1,600, basically.
Yeah.
But
this is something.
You are looking in today currency. I don't know how much was it. Like, I didn't earn this money in a day. Like, you know, it was a long period.
But I mean, the lira hasn't really changed. I mean, that's basically what I'm saying. You should buy lira now because the lira is super low. It's like compared to what it was like 4 years ago.
I have lira, man. Why should I buy it?
I'm talking about people that are not Turkish, you know.
Impossible. Everyone in the world is Turkish.
That one
Turkish
lira used to be zero. Damn. Yeah. I mean, I guess that's how it is to live in a poor country, you know.
He's upper class in Mexico, man. I would rather be upper class in Mexico than average or poor in Sweden.
I guess it actually is better to be rich in a poor country, you know, than to be rich in, like, I guess a semi...
I could tell you that right now.
I guess... There are problems. I mean, the chances of Lazul getting, or his family getting, like, robbed is probably higher than, like, some upper class right here in Sweden.
It probably is.
Well, at least I don't know how your gated communities are, you know.
My house has gates. Yeah.
Yeah, so it's like...
They are very gated, to be honest. Everyone in the upper class has gates and alarms also, So my house has an alarm, a gate, and in my room I have a spear. So that's it.
Yeah.
Well, by the way, this Afro dude is two meme. He has gone two meme, man. Like, I can't...
No, yeah, he's too fucking meme. He is literally a meme.
I mean, there is a... You can find the balance, I believe. That's what I believe, at least. Like, it
yeah.
doesn't have to go one way extreme. You just have to make meme jokes time to time, and you can just be a normal channel. I mean, it just... Like, I honestly don't want to do something like this, but... Yeah, what the fuck is this? This is just...
Yeah, it makes no fucking sense, right? Watch the fucking video and you're like, what the fuck? And it gets a lot of views. Like,
yeah.
He's just playing, he's painting like GIFs and also images about memes. Here,
but
there,
it
there,
has
there.
One fucking million! More
yeah,
than everything
yeah, no,
I
right?
created in my life!
It's because YouTube is filled with retards. And that's all you need to know. That's everything you need to know.
But if YouTube is filled with retards, don't be against it.
No, I know.
I mean,
I am a retard too, as well. Like, when I feel like...
Dude, I can understand, you know, dumb comedy, but, you know, like, stupid comedy.
Yeah.
I can understand that at some certain limit, but it just... This guy's gone full meme, man. Never go full meme.
Yeah. But you know what I mean, like...
Fuck it, man. Let's make meme videos.
Yeah, just make meme videos and get views.
I'm going to create a new channel just for the meme.
Just convert your old channel, come on.
Never! I don't wanna do that!
Gamer the memester.
No, it's not like I didn't ever play the meme games. Like, I mean... I played
and
meme
put games. Memes in your games, you mean? Ah, okay, I know what you mean. Like, Go Simulator and stuff like that.
Go Team what?
Goat Simulator.
That's a meme game, but that game is since that game is the first game of his species, like that game is the meme master because they created this genre, basically, like simulator shit.
Yeah, the fucking meme engines. What's up, Andreas? Go ahead.
It wasn't a Goat Simulator, basically just a parody of simulator games.
Yes, but you know Goat Simulator Gone Wild.
Well, I guess that was the thing about it, right? Wasn't it just supposed to be like, simulators are shit, here's a shit simulator. And then it became like, because aren't they Swedish? They come from... Creators of Goat Simulator, I think they are. Because I think we actually learned something about.
What do you think about this video? This masterpiece. Check this out.
Yeah,
let's see it.
Yeah. Oh God, that's an awful face.
Stretch.
Yeah, basically the typical video from the bed. I mean, if I wasn't like completely, nothing can stop.
Andreas, he laughed.
Huh?
I won.
No, I'm laughing because
it's ridiculously bad. Is that what you were going to say?
Yeah.
Yeah, but isn't it that the whole point of YouTube? Like, I believe that's the best point you can.
Yeah, nobody cares, to be honest, but. Where are the memes, dude? No, it's dude. Okay, to be honest. It's fucking pointless, I guess.
Live is
all. I mean, don't delete the video.
Oh, you want more awesome shit? No, but I'm going to send you anyway.
Yeah, send me shit, don't worry.
This video.
By the way, you have been making videos for a long time, right? So, have you at any point, have you had an intro to your channel?
Okay, I gotta send this vlog. All you need to do is just watch the first minute. Wait a minute. Okay. I cannot.
Is your intro a minute long?
No, it's just in the minute long.
Oh.
It's probably not even 1 minute, it was just 10 seconds or something. But that's the only intro I ever had.
You're liking this, don't you? Why are you liking my feet?
I hate concerts, yeah.
I really do, by the way.
Fuck you, man. I don't have any intro. Hi guys, I'm Gimmer the Barbarian.
Alright, so that was your intro. I don't have an intro.
Yes,
right. That's... Alright.
How meta.
Yeah.
Ah, okay, that's pretty good, really actually, meta. Dude. To be honest, that's very smart. I like that fucking intro. Because since everyone, all the YouTube fucking normies are using the intros and stuff like that.
Dude, but you know the worst kind of intro?
What is it?
Dubstep!
Oh yeah, fucking...
There is nothing makes me mad more than dubstep in the intro. If I wanted to fucking listen dubstep, I would!
Wait, who does that?
Oh. You wouldn't believe every tutorial.
Alright. I don't recognize any of that. But then again,
but it's everywhere, man. But maybe just because you watch quality YouTubers like Gamer the Barbarian. I mean,
yeah. Hey, by
just
the way,
the
Barbarian,
highest quality.
Barbarian, by the way, are you eating right now?
Yeah, I'm eating watermelon.
I see.
Okay, I'll stop now.
God damn it, makes me want to eat watermelon because we have hair as well.
Watermelon is the most beautiful thing in the world. Because it got the nutritions, it got low calorie, it got water, it got every kind of stuff.
And it has a lot of potassium.
Don't we need potassium?
Yeah, I said it has a lot of potassium.
I thought you were trying to, like, you know. By the way, this is a perfect meme game. Shit.
But
I edit it like in my way. I don't put memes.
Ah, that's where you're fucking up.
Fuck me.
This is a problem, Andreas. How the fuck are we going to make Barbarian popular?
Yeah, I guess that's the live
question.
We are going to come with an answer to that.
We are going to come with an answer to that, don't worry.
We are going to YouTube great
one
again.
One day, dude.
We are going to make Gamer the Barbarian great again. Andreas,
yeah, exactly.
You found your title.
Yeah.
Yeah, for the podcast.
Reintroduce the Barbarian Empire.
By the way, did I mention collaboration with Andreas? Probably the best thing I have ever did in my YouTube career. if you can
see. Wait.
Yeah, because
it's collaboration. What?
No, I mean the podcast. Like podcasts with Andreas probably help more than collaborations with bigger channels. Because Andreas was so boring and I was so fun. No, I am joking.
So high energy,
yay!
Man.
You guys mean the previous podcast, right?
Yeah. Like first podcast, first couple of podcasts.
Okay. I felt in that podcast, the second one, I think, I felt like I carried there. I made most of the questions in that one. But in this one, I agree.
I mean, the podcast is basically just for me, for, you know, just to talk. I mean,
yeah.
Because yeah, I don't think any podcast I have ever come up with any topics or whatever.
At subjects, you know, we never have topics. That's also a kind of problem, but it's pretty chill to talk with you guys.
Yeah,
do you want
topics?
There are tons of topics, man.
No, fuck topics. At this point, it doesn't matter, dude.
Yeah.
At this point, let's just talk about whatever. And yeah, by the way, Andreas, I will start watching Waku this day, today, and Billion, which is pretty fucking good, by the way.
Wait, I didn't hear what you said after Wakfu, because you lagged out.
Okay, the thing is that before that I'm going to start watching Wakfu this day, because I already finished it with Evangelion, which is pretty fucking good, dude. You too.
Evangelion.
Yeah.
It's
probably one of the best animes I have seen in my life. Anime.
Hmm.
Is there with Cowboy Bebop and Code Geass and Cowboy Bebop and Evangelion are probably my favorite anime of all time.
I'll probably have to watch Code Geass. I have not watched
Code Geass. You will like it because it's very like it has a strategy and it's very basically Lelouch is like Napoleon Bonaparte, you know.
Oh. Yeah,
I watched
very
Geass, yay!
Yes, did you watch it?
Yes,
finally,
I love it. But it's been so long.
Actually, I don't know if it's my favorite anime. I'm not sure after Evangelion, to be honest. But goddamn, like Code Geass, the ending of Code Geass is so is the best fucking.
I mean, most anime I watch are just, you know, fucking harems, you know, and like. This girl is the best, and then the best girl always lose. They're like, well,
yeah,
you deserve hell. The main character, fucking burn.
Shit, man! It's been like 6 years since this show ended, but I think I watched this show when it was airing on in Japan. Wow.
Oh, yes, you mean right?
Code
yeah,
Geass, yes.
I watched it.
It was really
years,
cool,
like,
man.
Yeah, it was so fucking cool. I also watched Code Geass, like, I watched it twice. Because it's probably my favorite anime, I'm not sure.
Yeah, it's really good.
And did you know that it has an OVA, right? In France? Do you know about that?
I didn't understand.
Wait. Code Geass has
an OVA.
OVA. I don't know what OVA means, like, but it has like a spin-off
like
series.
OVAs are often like an extra, like episode or two, like after, you know.
So they get it in France?
Yeah, wait. No, they are in France. They are trying to conquer France and stuff like that.
Oh, right. I think I watch all of them, but like it's been 6 years.
No, yeah, it hasn't ended, dude. It has not ended. These are the characters, by the way. Lelouch is not the main character in that one. Actually,
wait,
I don't want to spoil. I wouldn't like to spoil Andrea, so I'm not going to say anything, but
we are too cool. What? How did it not end it?
What?
It should have ended.
I'm not sure if I have only seen like 3 episodes of that OVA. Because the 4th episode was not released by then, you know?
Uh-huh. Okay, let me just check this OVA.
I watched the second season. Akito Exiled. This is the name. This is the OVA, right?
Holy shit, man. Exiled. Look at this colorful subreddit. You see, make a video about code geese, like about theory of code geese, and get views from Reddit. But this subreddit is not that big.
You know what? In my channel, that's another thing I would like to do. I would like to make like anime reviews because I have watched, holy shit, fucking more than 50 animes.
Oh.
Then. Like good animes, no harem and stuff like that. Not like to jerk.
Harem and Mua bluffs are the best.
You lost Andreas when you said there is no harem.
Yeah, but I'm saying like animes with actual stories, you know. My favorites are those ones. Yeah, so. It will be cool to make to do anime reviews and also like troll reviews, you know, like I make up the story of the anime, so I make all the fans of that anime mad, you know. It will be pretty good to get that reaction.
Yeah, it will probably work.
Like for example, Full Metal Alchemist. Like I could say that it has two main protagonists. Full Metal Alchemist has like Alphonse, which is the brother, and also he has a. Full Metal Alchemist, who is the main character, and be trolling like that, like say bullshit.
Yeah, or just call like the Chimera like a Manticore instead.
Yeah.
You know,
change everything, you know, to make people mad, like to make people believe I'm retarded or something like that. It will be pretty funny, but I will have to make it like that serious, you know, because if you are going to make a troll review, you have to be.
Yeah, you have to like be a good actor. God damn it, now when I look like 90% of every anime I've watched is like harem.
It's okay, dude. Do whatever you like, you know, but I don't like harem, to be honest. Oh no. My god, cool.
I enjoy
that video
it because
called?
There's
I'm video? Looking for one for a troll video. I'm looking for a troll video. That's pretty good.
Yeah. Because harems are good in a way that you don't actually have to know anything about anything. You can just watch them. They're often like 13 episode max.
Yeah.
And nothing happens. There's no difference. Other than, you know, you can see some best girls.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah, and also the porn is basically, you know, the porn of harems that get released are pretty good. That's basically why I recommend harems.
I need to find that troll. By the way, have you watched my list of videos in my channel, the ones I have on the internet? They are pretty fucking...
Is it videos that you made?
No. Those are videos like, they are fucking autistic. Here, I found it. Fucking video. Fine.
Oh, they're internet.
No, here. Let me like link you to it because...
Like,
this is
operating melee, right?
No, this is the video. I mean, that's the one.
Okay,
that guy trolls.
9 gig for life!
Watch that video, dude. He trolls very, very, very nicely. I think that the only part he fucks up is when he chose the symbol. But that's it. He should say that thing to the end.
Do you wanna see troll my little boys?
I think that guy trolls very well because he's dead serious, you know. This was back when 9gag had like a war with 4chan, which was very funny.
Basically like trolling the 4chaners.
Yeah, obviously, yeah.
This video is for all you stupid fucking trolls and haters on
me. Fuck, man.
And hurtful things about fedoras. Your life's dependent on it because you know what? I'd implore you to do a little bit of thinking, if that's even possible.
Why the silence? What happened?
I'm watching the video.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I'm just fucking tired. Oh, God.
If you guys want to stop, do so. Don't worry.
No, it's fine. I mean,
how long has it been?
We can go until one of us drops.
I will drop them probably because I got videos deaded, but.
By the way, Andreas, please, yep. we talk a lot of bullshit in this podcast, so if you can, please edit most of the bullshit out of this shit, of this video, you know.
I'll do my best.
Try to find...
In that case, don't expect this video to come out in at least 2 weeks.
Yeah, if you do that, right? Yeah, probably. But you know what I mean, like, it has a lot of dead air and stuff like that, so...
Yeah,
all the irrelevant shit, like, take that shit out.
Honestly, most of the dead airs are, like, is there because I was expecting a respawn, and I there's a delay, but I am also expecting a respawn. So it makes this environment weird.
I guess.
Yeah. Yes, great. That's a great idea, Andreas. Responding with delay. And I know that, like, you heard it the moment I said it.
Yeah.
I wasn't saying that to you. I was saying to Lazul because, like, whatever I say, there's a delay between me and Lazul, and I guess it's same with you.
Yes.
Fuck you!
But, I don't know. I don't feel like there's a delay between... There might be a delay between you two. Because... Or we're just, you know... slow people.
There is delay, I think so. I think there's delay because we are very far from each other. I'm in Mexico, you're in Sweden, and Barbarian is in Turkey. You know, so yes, in fact, there is delay.
Yeah, how long the delay is, who knows?
Yeah. I'm in another continent. At least Barbarian is in the same continent as you are.
I mean, that's debatable. Let's not go into that topic.
It's debatable if Turkey is European or Asian.
Let's not get into that topic.
Well you live in Ankara, don't you?
Yes.
So you're in Asia.
Yes.
I will say that Turkey is Middle Eastern. Not Asian, not European.
Yes.
But yeah, it doesn't even fucking matter. It's just how the place are called.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I'm just going to sell my Pokemon accounts and go to America with my girlfriend.
Oh, wait. Do your girlfriend lives in USA?
No, with my girlfriend. No.
Okay,
I don't want to leave her here, obviously. And I don't even go to, USA. I always thought that will be easier because she's going to be a doctor. And I think doctors for doctors, it's easy to get a passport, right? Is it like that?
Oh, yeah.
I'm not...
To get a working visa, you know?
Yes,
yeah.
I mean, because they are fucking doctors, so, and I am assuming she wouldn't leave me behind.
Who knows?
No, Andreas, she wouldn't. That was just a simple joke. Dude, you don't understand. I am her everything. What the? She doesn't even wouldn't want to go to foreign countries if I wasn't with her.
Huh.
Well, as long as she's loyal, everything's fine, dude.
But she also knows, like, it's going to be better if we go there. We go anywhere.
Yeah, as long as it's not, you know, to the east of Turkey, it should be better.
You learned too much, you fucking bastards! Now you become an enemy.
Yeah.
Wallah Akbar!
No.
Okay, what's happening, Barbarian? Are you okay?
No, I am okay. What happened? Are you talking about in general?
Yeah.
In general, in life?
Yes, let's go deep in your life. What's happening?
What the fuck is going on, man?
What are your plans for the future?
What are my plans? Oh god, fucking damn it, man.
No, not more YouTube talk.
Okay, apart from YouTube, I'm going to change
your
course.
Your plans for your life, dude.
Lives?
Yeah, your plans for your life.
Like, yes, okay, I mean... I said apart from YouTube. Andreas just yelled, no, not more YouTube. That's
yeah, so
why.
I mean, like 70% of the recording time is us bitching about YouTube.
Fuck YouTube. I'll show him. I'll get bigger and I'll show YouTube.
Yeah.
Andreas, God damn it.
Yeah,
anyway, okay, let me just say that I'm going to change university and I'm going to go to Bolu, where I record the vlog. And it's a small city. I like small cities. There is less traffic, less human, more peaceful for me. And I'm going to live with my friends. I'm not sure if I'm going to take my computer. So all I will have is my cell phone. I'm hoping that I will continue to make video editing, but since I don't have my computer, like I'm trying to make the video editing when as much as I can do while I'm here, so that I can collect more money, save more money. And
wait, why would you leave without your computer? Or are you saying just for a holiday?
Did you watch the vlog?
Which one?
I got only one vlog, man. Wait, that's not true. The vlog I recently sent. Anyway, the room is really, really small. Like, his house is really small and he got only one room. One plus one.
He's poor or what?
His home.
What do you
mean? His home.
Okay, he's home. Okay, he's home.
Yeah,
he has a small house, right?
Yeah, I'm going to stay with them for a while, with him for a while, and he got a small house, so, like, I don't know where to put my computer, but I want to take it, of course.
Yeah.
You should take it.
I don't want to live anywhere without my computer. God damn, it's so terrifying. Even...
Just throw out some of his stuff and put your computer.
Yes, that's what you should do.
Yeah,
people open their home to you.
Make up some space there. That's it, dude.
That's not my home. That's the thing. I'm going to stay them at them for a while.
With his parents?
Yeah. I'm sure you can explain to them. I fucking need my computer. And that's it.
You didn't see the house, but I understand. I mean, I can't say that. I just don't want to be a jerk. Like, I don't want to be the...
Well, I mean, how big, how much space do you really need for a computer? And maybe you can just use one monitor instead of two. There you go.
Fuck you, Andreas. You fucking... We don't have two monitors!
Barbarian. Only you do, dude. So, Barbarian.
Yes.
Do you, does that dude, your friend, right? Does
yeah,
he live alone, or...
Yeah,
he lives alone. Or... Okay, oh, that's pretty comfy, dude, already. So, move with all your stuff. Bring your computer, dude.
Yeah, I'm hoping I could bring it.
How much time are you going to stay there?
I'm going to study in college there. I'm going to college for there. Because
okay.
I don't want to stay here. I want to go there. It's just the one thing I love about Western families is that like they know to let go. Like when you are 18, I don't think any Western family would oppose you to go to college in another city. And I am 21 and I am still facing these issues. Like, Turkish families are more protective and more annoying.
Conservatives, you mean, or what?
Conservative? What did you say?
They're more conservative.
Yeah.
Like.
Not because of that. Like, I mean, my girlfriend's family is like that, but... My family is not like that because my mom recently started to act different because I am going away. She can't take this and she's acting like a child. I told her I was going away like a long time ago, but she's acting like a child. Like if I was in a Western family, it will be easier to let go because like. Andreas, do you think your mom would opposite you, when you oppose you when you said, if you say I'm going another city for college, like even if you were 18?
Yes, because
really?
Of my sickness.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
But other than that,
I mean, no, because before the sickness, even when I was much younger, I could go to the. Where the fuck I wanted.
Yeah, I mean...
You know, as long as she knew and all that.
Yeah.
But ever since I started getting sick, like, maybe 7 years ago, 8 years, who knows. Fuck, it's 7 years now. That's when it changed. It's like, because I've gotten, like, completely spurg outburst here and there, and I've been able to stop reading sometimes. So it's like, all right, now it's not like that anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But I know what you mean. Like, when you're 18, they're like, alright, you're an adult now, it's your life.
Yeah,
you can
I am
choose.
Okay with that. I mean, I want that to happen to me. Like, we were talking about this with my girlfriend, and would you rather choose, would you rather to live with a Western family or Eastern family? Like, I mean, they're going to let you go when you're 18, but you know, I mean, we would prefer a Western family.
Me too.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
How is your family, Lazo? Except, you know, I know they are rich. I mean, come on, don't rub it in our faces.
Well, yeah, my dad is pretty fucking, like, he's pretty fucking cool. Like, I fucking love my dad, man. Because he lets me do whatever the fuck I want, basically.
Mm,
if I need money for something, like for my computer I'm going to build, he's going to contribute more than 80% of the money in there, like, basically. So, yeah, my dad is pretty fucking cool, and he lets me be whatever the fuck I want, like, you know? If I want, like, a radical change, like, if I wanted to be, like, a punk rocker one day, like, get my hair like in a fucking crest and dye it, I don't know, fucking green or in whatever, he will let me do whatever the fuck I want, you know?
I mean,
he knows how to
mm-hmm.
What?
In some senses, my father would let me to become anything I want because he doesn't care,
yeah.
But I mean,
Yeah, it's the same here. So I guess what we all have in common is that our parents are pretty liberal compared to the rest.
Yeah, like
that we live around.
But we mean like, we mean socially liberal. Like we don't mean like in a liberal, you know, in American liberal way, you know.
Yeah.
You know how we mean. Like our parents are not social justice warriors, you know. They are liberal in the pure sense of the word.
Yeah.
Mm.
Which is pretty fucking amazing. Like, in my opinion, those are good parents, I think. Because I'm not going to go out to be a druggie, you know. I'm not going to be a stoner because I don't like weed, you know. They will let me choose that part if I want it, but I don't want to, you know.
That's cool, man. You are really lucky.
Yeah, the fact that our parents basically like, they trust us to make our own decisions, and they're like, well, at least I can just speak for myself. It's like, do your own decisions, and then, depending on the results, she might help or not, you know? I mean, if I start to go become a murderer, I don't think my mom is going to, you know, help me murder people, but... Do you know what I mean?
Now that you bring that topic, like, I do think
like,
that...
As long as I don't hurt anyone else, who cares?
Yeah, same as me, but I do think like if I killed someone, my dad will help me hide the body if I called him. I'm sure of it. Like he trusts me that much. I don't know, he wouldn't like me to go to jail, you know, even though I deserved it or something like that. If I wanted to get out of there, like,
It must be because of the jail system. I'm pretty sure Mexican jails are much worse than Swedish.
Because in Sweden,
our jails are more rehabilitation, you know.
Yeah.
It's basically like a hotel.
Yeah, like Breivik in Norway, you know?
Breivik,
right? He killed a lot of people and he went into a cell that had a pretty nice room with a bed and everything, like, everything was so clean.
Does it have internet? Yeah, if it does have internet, I am okay with going jail in Sweden.
For him, they did not let him have internet. But he does have, like, I think a PlayStation 3 and a television and all that. And, I mean, he's allowed to write stuff and blah, blah, blah. But they do make some exceptions for cases like Breivik because they're like, oh, he's going to inspire other people to go out and kill.
No, not only that, dude. He could like give code to make bombs to random dudes in the internet if he wanted, because he knew how. He was very smart, to be honest. He was a criminal and all that, a terrorist basically, but he was very fucking smart. You know, Breivik, right, Barbarian?
I know what?
Do you know who Anders Breivik is?
Breivik, that guy.
Yeah, of course. Put it in chat.
Yeah. That's basically who we're talking about now.
Yeah, I know. I realized that. I mean, he killed, he terrorist. Yeah, I realized that.
I mean, in Sweden at that time, there were a lot of, you know, jokes going around. You know, about... Because he did it at a summer camp.
Yeah, he was...
And people are like...
They were teaching him...
I'm going to have to cut this. Three hours.
Yes, what did you say? What are you going to cut?
Well, I'm gonna cut all of that, but popular. Yeah, I mean, we have recorded for 3 hours.
Oh shit! Oh. It's been 3 hours.
Yes.
Okay, because I am seeing only 2 hours, I forget about the first hour we recorded. But anyway, continue.
Like, that he was a teacher in that summer camp to teach kids how to swim.
Yes.
And if because they didn't learn, summer they camp, would die.
Yeah, but I mean, because the joke is, because most of the people he shot were trying to swim away from the island.
Oh, yeah. Irony!
Yeah, so that was like the joke, that he taught kids how to swim by, you know, being like, if you can swim away, then you will survive.
Whatever.
Here you go.
Whatever, man. Let's just find a viral video idea that is going to keep the channel growing. Like, it's not going to be a one-time hit. And let's make that video and split the profit, be rich, fuck bitches, go to USA. I know that guy, by the way.
Your channel, you mean, right, Barbarian?
No, I mean, if you have a, like, interesting idea, we could create a new channel just for that idea. It's not like it's hard. What are you sending?
Well, you can make a...
Yeah, yes, I know this guy. Why do you keep sending me this guy?
Because it's the joke we were talking about previously.
But yeah, anyway, I understand. No problem. Yes.
But what kind of video do you think that Barbarian can make to get famous, Andreas?
Andreas doesn't even think for himself, man.
I mean, my answer is always the same.
Horse.
Either spill it, like, pump it with, like, memes everywhere. Or, like...
And share it on Reddit or 4chan. If it has memes, share it on those platforms, you know?
Yeah, or do, like, this shitty top 5, top 10, so whatever, you know?
Yeah, okay, the thing you don't understand is the place, the platform to promote. There is no place to promote your top 10 videos. I don't think there is, at least. Like, except Reddit.
Depends on the topic, dude.
What?
If you're talking about a top 10 about Dark Souls, you know, like top 10 weapons in Dark Souls, you can advertise that shit on the Dark Souls Reddit or the 4chan BG, on 4chan BG Dark Souls General, you know?
Yeah, I guess.
Maybe you could, like, it's possible.
Okay, do you have your top 10 weapons?
I would like to make that shit, but first I need a good computer. If you want to make it, it's still the idea for me, if you want it.
It's just, to make that video, all you need is, like, footage from internet, right? You don't really need to own the game.
Yeah, you're right. I could use, like, videos using those weapons, you know?
Yeah, because Dark Souls is kind of a game that's, like, everybody makes, like, people make... Even though it has a small community compared to, like, GTA 5, it has I don't know, researcher community, right? And at least that's how I feel like. Because there is a video about every fucking weapon, and, like, I admire that, man. I mean, it exists.
Yeah, they are dudes that bother to play, like, with every single weapon 30 minutes of their life, and...
Like, I am kind of impressed.
I could make, like, a tier list about the weapons in Dark Souls. It would be pretty good. I actually made a tier list with the great swords, with the ultra great swords, sorry. Which was pretty easy because there are only, like, 10 ultra great swords in the game.
Alizu, do you want to yes.
What?
Do you wanna try
In your channel, you mean?
I mean, we can create a new channel. Like, because I can do this, I mean, it's not a problem. to progress is not
but
a problem.
What do you mean? I would like to have that video on my channel, to be honest, not somewhere else, you know.
Yeah, I understand.
But if you want to do that video, go ahead, man, do it. Make a tier list about the great shorts if you want.
I wouldn't steal your idea. I could make it for you too. But it just, do you think it's going to become big or, you know, relatively big?
Yes, and you know why? Because I will put the link of the video. I will spam the shit out of the video in 4chan, in BG, in Dark Souls General.
Just tell me the weapons, and you know, if you have a voiceover, do you think you could do voiceover? I mean, I could do voiceover, but I mean, I'm not really.
No, the video, I could make that fucking video if I wanted to, but.
Uh-huh.
I would like the footage of that video to come from myself, you know, like mm-hmm. from me recording the game, and I would like to have like me PvPing, not someone else, but maybe
like relevant footage.
Yeah, but maybe you're right. Maybe I should like not give a fuck and you know, fucking make a video, you know. here's the tier list I made.
Yes. I mean, you could do it, yeah, but I think you should try it.
Yeah, and you're right. Maybe I should like steal the footage of each weapon from a lot of YouTubers that have used that weapon.
You don't have to steal it. Like, you could just give them credit.
Well, yeah, that
will work. That's not stealing. You are giving credits. You are.
Mm-hmm. And I could make that fucking video in day one. Like it will be pretty fast because it's under one topic, you know. It's not an entire
uh-huh.
tier list. Because yes. if you were to do like an entire tier list of Dark Souls, there are like more than mm-hmm. 100 weapons, you know. That's fucking uh-huh. crazy.
Anyway, man, I think we should finish this. Wait, what did you send? Oh, Ultra
it's
Great
like it
Sword. Oh my
yeah,
god, I fucking love Fum Ultra Great Sword. I use that shit all the time in Dark Souls 2.
Yeah, but. It was nerfed. In Dark Souls 3, it was nerfed, so...
Yeah, I good thing I didn't use in Dark Souls 3.
Mm-hmm. I made that tier list like 1 month ago, something like that, I don't remember.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that's who I think it will be.
But dude, I think...
Actually, sweet,
I
Andreas,
should probably make one of these.
What, Andreas?
I should probably make one of these, like, top 10 weapons that Roderick have used.
Yeah,
at the end of the story.
Black Halberd is number one. And
Black Knight Halberd takes all the spots.
Okay,
yeah,
man.
Pretty cool.
Okay, people, guys, it's been, I think, more than 3 hours. I think we should stop now.
Yeah. 3 hours and 8 minutes.
Yes. Let's just stop. Let's stop.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what, Roman?
Okay, wait. Are you going to do outro or something?
Okay, one final thing. I think I will make that fucking video in Sony Vegas. I will start like this week.
Great, man.
Yeah, but the footage,
correct.
I will take it from other guys, like not from myself. But.
All you need to do is give credits in description so you don't get in trouble. Because top 10 videos, I think, can be in fair use because, you know, they have an educational value about them. I mean, I don't know how true is this, but they're kind of educational.
But just give credit. I agree. Just give credit where credit is due.
Yeah, I mean, that's all.
You know?
Anyway, Andreas, do you have any outro?
Don't do drugs, kids.
Oh, shit.